Hello! Welcome back to another art vlog. And I'm actually really excited for this week because I think we're gonna start doing our art plates. If you don't know what plates are, it's basically like art projects, but to make it fancier, more professional, I guess they call it plates now. But yeah, today is Monday and it's like 7:50 p.m. It's kind of weird to start a vlog at night. The whole day I didn't have the energy and time to vlog because I almost got late to class and I had to sit in front of the laptop for 5 hours and I got tired and lazy, and one thing led to another and here I am. It's not too late to start. I'm about to do an essay. I think it's still due a week from now, but I want to get things done right away because I'm pretty sure my schoolwork is just gonna pile up. I'm gonna get stressed and I don't want that, so let's go. Science quiz. Yeah. Hello. Voiceover Jana is back. Okay, so before we continue, let me explain the situation. I know the title kinda sounded concerning, like, no, I did not fail this plate, don't worry. Actually, I still don't know my grade for this plate as I am editing this, so, I don't know. So I was assigned my first art plate, which was to express softness or playfulness using lines, and also express sadness, melancholy, or chaos using lines as well. So basically I had to pass two outputs. The deadline was assigned on the Wednesday of the next week, so I wanted to get it done right away, and the plan was to finish it within the week so I wouldn't have to work on it on the weekend. So that's what I did. That's actually what I am doing in this clip. In this clip, I am trying to use really fine lines and I'm using my watercolor pencils. I'm using really fine lines to make a soft kind of environment and scene and kind of make it look like chill and easy to the eyes. I was really happy with this output and how the final work ended up like. I actually also ended up finishing the other output, the one where I had to express sadness, melancholy, and chaos with lines, and that output was harder than the first one, the one I'm doing now, but this is where things went downhill. Like, I was able to finish the two outputs before the weekend, so I thought I was gonna be free. I thought I would have time to do other stuff, but no. Well, guess what? I had to do everything all over again. Yay! Sounds fun! But even if this output wasn't the one that I passed to my teacher, I'm still gonna show it anyway, because otherwise if I don't show it, then it would kind of be a waste. Ugh. I really like this output too, so I felt sad not being able to pass it to my teacher. Basically, I couldn't pass it because on the weekend, I think it was on the weekend, that's when my teacher actually posted detailed instructions on how to do the plate. So, yeah, Maybe I got too overexcited. I really should have waited for my teacher's instructions. It wasn't only me who experienced this. I had some other classmates who also finished the project before our teacher actually gave the instructions. So we had to do everything all over again. My classmate even said, like, maybe procrastination actually is good. I'm just kidding. Take what I said with a grain of salt. Don't take it so seriously, guys. Yeah. So yeah, actually what we were supposed to do was, first of all, there are measurements for the margin, so yeah, I already did not follow that first instruction. Then second, I wasn't supposed to use color, and I was actually supposed to use ink and not colored pencils. Yeah, I did it all over again. It's unbelievable. Anyways, I'm gonna show you all the drawing processes, the final plate that I passed to my teacher, and I'm showing you the one that I did before also, because I just want to share it. Like, at least I was able to practice how... Yeah, at least I was able to practice, right? I have to redo everything! More content, I guess.